So we're taking this opportunity because we know that the West Nile virus is in our mosquito populations here in Saskatoon, and because the weather continues to be warm, and also because there has been interest, because the United States in particular has had a worse West Nile virus season than we've seen in a long time. Just taking this opportunity to remind people about prevention measures against West Nile virus, which of course include using mosquito repellents, wearing protective long clothing, staying indoors at dawn and at dusk when the mosquitoes are most active, and then of course decreasing the chance of mosquito breeding grounds around your property by draining standing water.
So how significant is it to find a mosquito or mosquitoes in the city of Saskatoon for the first time in 5 years?
Yeah, so that's a good question. We do mosquito surveillance throughout the West Nile virus season, and that's an ongoing program that's done every year. So overall, we know that the mosquito population in Saskatchewan and in Saskatoon has been low this year. So finding a single pool that's been positive, it is significant, but take that as just a single pool, and indeed it has been. Surveillance in the weeks following that have not indicated that further mosquito pools have been positive. But what it does tell us is that the virus is present in our mosquito populations here in Saskatoon.
If this single mosquito bit me, what are my risks?
Yeah, so we know that the West Nile virus is spread through the bite of an infected mosquito. We also know that in Saskatchewan, there isn't enough population level immunity to ensure that people are protected. So the majority of people would still be at risk for West Nile virus if bitten by an infected mosquito.
Do you have any guesstimation of what percent of people in Saskatoon and Saskatchewan might be immune to West Nile based on previous exposure?
Yeah, at this point we don't know. We did a bit of a surveillance study a number of years back. I'm sorry, I can't remember the exact number, but it was low enough that we're confident that there isn't wide-level population immunity in Saskatchewan.
Like it's nominal, like less than 5%?
I think it's about that, but I will check and I can get back
sorry,
to you.
So that less than 5% are susceptible?
Are not susceptible, would have been infected in the past. So the vast majority are still susceptible to West Nile virus.
That's what I was
thinking. Yeah.
Okay, thank you.
And what does a mosquito pool mean?
So the way we do surveillance for West Nile virus is that we trap mosquitoes overnight at a number of surveillance sites around the city. So if the mosquitoes trapped at those sites are sorted by mosquito species, and the Culex tarsalis mosquito is separated out, and those mosquitoes are tested for West Nile virus. So that pool from that one night is a mosquito pool.
So you're collecting mosquitoes once a week, every week? Is that right?
They're collected on a nightly basis, and then the surveillance is reported to us on a weekly basis.
If someone is susceptible and they are bitten and infected, can you remind us what are the initial things that happen to them and what the stages they go through?
Yeah. So with West Nile virus, the majority of people would have no symptoms whatsoever. About 80% of people show no symptoms when they're infected with West Nile virus. For the 20% or so, the most common symptoms of West Nile virus are fever, headache, muscle aches, generally feeling unwell. Some people can have swollen lymph nodes or a rash. And then for a small minority, less than 1%, the consequences of West Nile virus infection can be much more severe. These people develop a West Nile virus neurological syndrome, which causes meningitis, and this is characterized by fever, headache, neck stiffness, even coma, and rarely death.
Can you tell us where in Saskatoon the trap was that found where the mosquitoes tested positive for the virus?
That trap was on the west side of the city.
Okay, and how many traps does the city operate, do you know?
I'm sorry, I don't have that number
okay.
on the top of my head.
I believe it's on their website.
Pardon me?
I believe
it's on the city of Saskatoon website.
I mean, how alarmed should people be that there might be kind of a repeat of 2007 where so many people not only got West Nile, but ended up with having the more severe neurological form of the virus?
Mm-hmm. And that's really difficult to predict. So we do West Nile virus surveillance, but we also do mosquito surveillance, and we base our risk predictions on a number of factors, including temperature, precipitation patterns, whether how mild the winter has been and whether the mosquitoes might have survived overwintering. Also what comes into play is bird migration and bird populations, because the virus is replicating in those populations. So all of those factors do come into play. So it's difficult to make a prediction on all of those factors for the coming year. So that's why it's really important to do surveillance on an annual basis and then to update our risk assessment on a weekly basis as we do.